And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
I'm just sitting here calm. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. Big J. Okerson, not in today. He is currently filming Blade 4. He got a part as a vampire hunter. Very excited for him. I think it's a role he was dressed to play. I'm just going to keep this going. Our guest from the Philly contingency, Bull of Bulls, Dog of Dogs, Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast, Shane Gillis.
Wow.
Shane Gillis.
Let's fucking get it, dude.
Yeah, let's fucking go.
Let's fucking get
Jay
it.
Jay is out killing vampires.
Fuck Jay.
No. Hey, what? No. Shane. God, no. Shane's so combative all the time. Shane is a constant, I think Shane on the inside's constantly the hugging scene from Step Brothers. That's Shane in his head. You're like, come on, Shane. He's like, fucking get
You're
away.
Trying to break me down last night, dude. We were talking Thrones.
Game of Thrones?
I was telling you who I genuinely like.
Your top five
My top
is
five.
Pure villains.
My top five
Name
Game
them.
Of Thrones.
Name your top five Game of Thrones.
Number one, undoubtedly, Joffrey.
Joffrey's your guy.
King Joffrey was the best.
I mean, you just like the way he asshole. Worked?
I just liked just a fucking inbred dude trying to get through life.
He's not trying to get through life. Now. He's trying to dominate, dude. He was hurting people.
Fuck yeah.
You like a guy that puts a hurt on someone?
Yeah. He like found a crossbow at one point.
Yeah, that was like, dude, like that's the scene where everyone's like, no. When you saw Joffrey in Game of Thrones get the crossbow.
Joffrey carried the first couple seasons.
So, yeah. I mean, yeah, he did push
He's
it along.
The
He's
best.
Like, he, as a guy who loves that. So you, Joffrey's your number one.
Joffrey's number one.
Who's your number two?
Number two. Is
this is I think I know what you're
definitely Craster.
And explain who Craster is.
Craster is the guy who lived north of the wall that just had a fucking den of his own daughters. He was fucking.
That's your number two guy. That's the guy that also feeds his sons to the living.
Yeah, he gives
to the
birth.
Night,
to yeah, the- he gives birth to his future prospects. Sick. And then if it's a boy, he just feeds it to the zombies.
Are you saying you respect Craster because he uses a renewable resource?
Exactly.
His renewable fuel?
That's the green energy we needed. That's the Green New Deal.
Inbreeding.
That's the Green New Deal.
Shane Gillis is here to tell you inbreeding will leave a lower carbon footprint.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Number three, Hound. Like his attitude.
I could have told you from the get-go, before we even had this conversation, if you're like, who is top five Shane's characters? I would have said Mountain. Because I think you like a dead guy that comes back to dominate.
I like the dead guy that is now just a giant moron. That's pretty funny. It's funny to watch him operate.
Mountain?
The Mountain, yeah.
Yeah, but so you're taking Hound over Mountain.
True. You're right about this. On paper, I should like the Mountain more.
I just like
the Hound's attitude.
If I was Mel Kiper in your fucking Game of Thrones draft, I'd be like, Shane Gillis, really high up on the Mountain, loves a guy that's just mean, that crushes heads, that's been dead a little bit. He's got a good strength. He's a fighter.
Yeah.
He's loyalty. His loyalty lies in evil.
Banging
he burned his own son. I mean, his brother. What?
Banging a nun.
He banged a nun?
Not against
her. Oh, yeah.
Against her will.
Oh, boy.
Remember that nun
yeah,
that
Cersei,
made Cersei do the
that
walk.
That shamed Cersei?
Oh, yeah.
She fucking fed her ass to the fucking Mountain.
So are you moving the Hound and putting in the Mountain?
Nah, I'm keeping...
Man, Joffrey just looks like such a little bitch.
Joffrey was the man.
Best.
His little fucking cheekbones.
Wow, you like him too, Jacob?
I loved him. That
Hell
kid
yeah.
retired. He retired after act. He's not acting anymore.
That's a walk-off, that's why.
Yeah, or also it's you getting threatened at Ralph's at fucking 11:30. You're an 11-year-old getting shit-talked to you by men. They're like, fuck you!
A couple
like,
British dudes.
Yeah, oh, look who it is. Oh, King Joffrey.
If it isn't Joffrey.
Hi, Joffrey, you're going down the produce aisle right now. He's like, hey, guys, I'm actually from...
For the last time, it's just a joke. It's a story.
I got cast on it, please, mister.
Yeah, quit your lie. This is bollocks.
This is for the Starks. Bend them over. The North doesn't forget.
Oh, also, I didn't think about it. The Giant. The Giant's a great character.
You got a
Giant.
Got, right, so your top five right now are Joffrey.
Joffrey, Craster, Hound. I'm going the Giant. The Giant.
The one that got dropped by the little
girl. That was a wildling. But then he was the man when he was a wildling.
Yeah.
And, like, was fighting with Snow and them. But then after death, he came back to squeeze that dumb little girl character.
Come on.
Yeah.
She's on my top five.
Do you like her?
She loved, dude.
Oh.
And by the way, if you didn't
that
think
makes
it was,
you a pervert, dude.
I should,
no, man.
It, we spun out into a Game
Great
of Thrones
character.
Talk, but this is just such a, this is, you see Shane for, you know, the bull that he is. Your draft picks are very indicative of...
Jeez, who's number five? Hodor. Hodor's a great number five for me.
Hodor's a good, he's like a good swing forward.
It's literally, it's like drafting a center.
Yeah, he's just there. He's a good right guard.
Yeah. Hodor's a great.
He's just going to block for you.
Hodor also had a huge dick. Remember they brought that up?
Did they?
Yeah, Hodor had a huge dong.
I bet. He's got lower intelligence, so God had to give him the gift of a human skin hammer.
Can we talk about that?
What?
I was just talking about that. Oh, with Matt on the Secret Podcast. I was talking about
download Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast.
If you
have
a tiny teenus,
yeah,
you can take on the world, dude.
If you have a tiny dick?
If you have a teenus, just a small, tiny teenus.
Why is it teenus, though? Just because it's a tiny penis?
Yeah. You're teenus? Ready to fucking take on everything.
So a teenus is the fuel to fucking...
If you got a big dong, you're just hanging out. You're a idiot.
Yeah, you're like Eeyore.
Yeah.
You're just swinging around.
You got a teenus, you're out fucking attacking people.
There are some dicks that feel too small.
We both looked at Christine. We both looked at Christine like she was talking. We're like, what's up?
God,
you know that I've slept with many men and some of them had small dicks.
Stop it. I will not let you talk like that when your love and my love, Jay, is not here. Speaking of Jay and the city of Philadelphia that Shane graced for so many years, big shout out to the 76ers beating the Raptors.
Hey.
In Toronto. This goes out to Big J on set of Blade 4, killing all those stripper vampires. It is such a better song.
Yeah.
It's just good.
This song actually holds up, like, just hanging out.
You know what it does? It has a Schoolhouse Rocks kind of vibe. Series tied 1-1.
Yep.
How late did you guys watch the game, Christine? Did you watch it?
Skanks.
After Skanks. So
midnight?
Yeah, so you're up till 2:30. You probably finished the game when Nuggets game did. Oh, yeah. I'll wait. Because you got to get to the chorus. I would never cut anyone off. There it goes. Ah, I jumped. Oh.
Team of the year, bro. Team of the year.
Sixers. Hit him with the nuts, Lou.
76ers.
76ers.
So there you go. Sixers winning and also winning last night after the Sixers won. It was a bonfire day in the NBA because the fucking Denver Nuggets took a one lead.
The fucking dank Nugs,
the
dude.
The dank fucking.
Taking care of business.
The chronic
the
Nuggets.
The fucking dank ass Nugs.
Taking care of fucking business.
Yo, what even is a Spur, dude?
Are we going to you start doing
what's
ideas?
Even a fucking, no one even knows what a Trailblazer is, dude.
Dude, shut up, bro.
You fucking better knock me out.
Yeah.
You better get that knockout.
Where's that Nugget song at? Yeah!
Oof.
It sucks. It sucks. In the break, we're as fast as the wind. We force the play from end to end. Jump, jump, the fine. Because we're the Denver Nuggets friend. So bad. We're going to
go with the Nuggets. It sounds like a musical about the Nuggets.
Here it is. It's like this.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Atlantic City.
It's like one of those show things.
We bring you the Denver Nuggets.
Yeah, good win. It was a good win. I was very happy about that. 1-0 in the series. This work is right here. We got a defense that hustles and offense with muscle. We're gunning for the win tonight. Gunning for the win tonight. Don't get in the way.
Notre Dame has one of these.
Do they really?
If you want to find it, it's by a guy named Bass Freak.
Bass Freak?
Bass Freak.
So is it recent? Because that sounds
It was like 2012, maybe.
Oh, wow.
It's brutal.
This is 76, so you
really
know
makes
what.
You hate Notre Dame more than you already do, probably.
So is it brutal in the fact that it's trying to be good?
It's the most corny shit possible. This is...
Come on, I mean...
You'll see. This has a music video.
It's called Bass Freak?
I think it's... Try Bass Freak Notre
Dame.
Oh,
there's a music video that goes along with it?
The music video is the worst.
I would jerk off a sleeping homeless man to have a music video to this
hey,
Denver Nuggets.
Hey, man.
Oh, what's up, buddy?
Hey, you're waking me up out of my sleep.
Who are you, hot hands?
Whoa.
Oh, coming in like Mr. Miyagi style.
Hey, mister, you're going to make me bust.
Oh, you want me to pop?
I'm going
to
pop all of my fucking newspapers.
Oh, watch out. You ever seen cum in a sleeping bag?
This old bag's been a
god, this bag.
His bag's full of cum.
It's like a burrito with sour cream now.
Oh, you just supremed my sleeping bag. You just made a supreme sleeping bag. All filled with jism. I want to see this music video because a sports team making a music video besides the Super Bowl shuffle.
I could have sworn it was Bass Freak.
Yeah, Notre Dame's easy to hate.
Yeah, I get it.
There it is. There's you. There's constantly you being hugged.
Nah, dude, I try to hug you, and you're the weird one about hugs.
I am weird. I like touched.
I like touchies.
I'm like Warren from Something About Mary.
I'm big time touchies.
I'll rock you if you touch my ears.
I'll touch you.
I'll just fuck it.
Yeah, I was just talking to Sarah Tolmash about that.
What?
That, like, as great as, I mean, there's Something About Mary's like hilarious, but like the jokes are like, this retarded guy. Like, that's the punchline.
Dude, that's...
And then it's like, hey, Mary's dad's black.
Yeah.
Like, that's the punchline.
He's just like she's got a black stepdad. Yeah. Isn't that hilarious?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's great.
Still, I mean...
Holds up.
Holds up. Something About Mary holds up. Yeah, we were having an interesting conversation last night at the Comedy Cellar that I thought was a good question of what movie... Gary Goldman asked me, what movie would you show your son or daughter if you had a kid? And you showed them a movie at 10 years old and they didn't laugh, you would be disappointed in them. If you showed them
at
a movie.
10?
Yeah, like if I showed them Dumb and Dumber at 10 years old and they were like, or like 11 and they're like, nah, you just kind of be like, fuck, you don't like that?
Yeah, you got to show them like Ace Ventura.
That's what I thought. I had 12 or pre 10. Pre 10, Ace Ventura, a lot of slapstick
Schindler's
shit.
List.
Yes. Yeah, I was going to do Winter Bones. I wanted to do something. I was going to go Who Took Johnny, the Netflix documentary. Just let them know it's possible.
Hey.
If you're out there mowing the lawn, you might get swiped, and I might see you 19 years later on my front door for a brief hello.
I would, you got to show them shit you liked.
Yeah, but then I remember I used to be like Back to School. I don't know if that would hold up for a 10-year-old now. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's like a lot of shit that I feel like I would show them, like Robin Hood Men in Tights.
Yeah,
probably.
I don't think Back to School would hold up for me right now.
It's funny.
Yeah.
You just watch your tone. It's funny. I'm just saying. What was that? I like your tone.
Hey, let me tell you. No one's giving me any respect.
That's my brother. That's Ralph. Ralph Dangerfield. He's been trying to make a name off me.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Ralph. Oh, he's back in here.
Hey, take my wife's a bitch. Anyway.
All right. Hey, buddy, why don't you go outside, have a cigarette? Leave us alone. I'm sorry. He's a rough hang. Did you find the video?
Of the Notre Dame Bass
Freak? Yeah, what, did you just give up on us?
Yeah, she doesn't give up.
He didn't
fuck.
Know the name, and it's not coming up under Bass Freak, BSS or BASE.
It would be BASS.
Of course it would. I want to see this douchebag video for Notre Dame. I'm thirsty.
I'm going off.
For douche. I just, if you like being quiet, you just hear Christine and it sounds so official.
Oh, Freak Bass.
Freak Bass. That's even worse.
I think it's F-R-E-E-K, too.
Was it one of the, like, was it made by Notre Dame?
Freak Bass Notre Dame. Wait till you see how fucking corny this is.
Was it made by Notre Dame?
They definitely allowed it. Like, Notre Dame's head coach is in it. They film, like, in the gym. It's rough, dude.
We are Notre Dame. What?
That would be the shit. But that's not it.
That's not it?
No, it definitely wasn't fucking Wu-Tang.
I didn't know what it was. Were there several things playing? I'm high enough to the point that I'm like, that's a pretty cool video.
Yeah,
good job,
just
Notre Dame.
Casuals everything around me on this?
Yeah, they're like,
pretty crazy.
Can we license cream? And they go, man, that's a bold statement for a Catholic university to take.
Oh, and this was right after Manti Te'o.
Yeah, faking a girlfriend?
Yeah.
That might have been the most heartwarming story ever. Is this the dude faking his girlfriend? Is this it?
Yeah.
And look at this guy. Oh, this hurt. Victory
march. We'll tweet it out at the Bonfire SXM. What the fuck? This is 2012?
I think. Hard to watch.
It's like if your mom made a rap video. Also, their cheerleaders rough.
Yeah, dude, it's Notre Dame.
I know. You gotta
They're
get
smart.
Yeah, that's what I was waiting for you to snap back.
You're not going to have a bunch of fucking dumb hot chicks.
Why not? You're Notre Dame. You can break the rules. You're a private institution.
Bro, we only break the rules on boys. Young, hot boys.
Young, hot dudes, you guys. Bro. Look at all those fucking tight torsos on those boys. What?
Fuck, I forgot he has a rapper as his partner. The dude in the back.
I can't wait.
Wait, this is...
Does he spit bars about Joe Montana? That looks like a character.
Their tag is when 1972 meets 2072, it's 100% freak bass.
Oh. This is very cringy.
Yeah. This is right after Alabama.
Alabama came in not wearing pants to that national championship game. They're like, hey, Notre Dame, is that your linebacker with the fake girlfriend? We're about to give him some real dickin'. Is this not fun anymore?
That's not very fun.
I'm sorry.
Don't rub it in. I was going, yes. It's the fight team. I wish it to tuck. It's too hot. Gonna turn it up on the field for the heat. Gonna burn it up. Oh, my God.
This is dog shit. While the suns go marching on to resist the fear of the Irish. Oh, my God. It really does feel, this feels like teacher rap. Like
it
someone
is.
Was
it
like,
is. This is the type of shit Notre Dame would put out.
Yeah,
Notre Dame's corny as fuck.
There's this one lady that's like, how fun is this?
Dude, can
at
we
the
just
presentation?
Go back to Lou Holtz, lower the fucking standard so we can win a fucking game.
I want a mole looking, wrinkly sumbitch with a lisp that wins games.
Exactly, dude.
Come on, let's go.
How do you like me now? Now that my face is to you.
Yeah, what's going on? Lou Holtz here, just letting you know I'm winning ball games and slowly becoming a Sharpay.
Lou Holtz is the fucking dog.
Dude, when he gets all fired up on ESPN.
He's the best.
He successfully replaced Lee Corso as much as possible.
Yeah, Lee Corso had a fucking hard stroke, and they kept bringing him out.
But he's still back. Did you see him
leave? Yeah, they bring him out on College Game Day, and they're like, all right, Lee, what's your pick? He's like, I'll take the Chicago Cubs. Like, Jesus Christ, man.
Lee, it's like Dick Clark where they propped him up for one last.
It really is.
Yeah, that was rough.
Except this is for like 5 years now.
Yeah, but it's
post-stroke Corso.
But
like,
Dick Clark had to have like charming energy, so he's like, hey, everybody, welcome back. And you're like, please stop this. Whoever's holding him up, please put him down.
Mm.
Yeah, that's rough, man. It's one of those things where that's where you see how evil fucking networks are, where they're like, is Dick ready to go? And they're like, we think he's breathing. We think he's like, I want you to prop him up. Oh, that's the album cover? Oof. Freak bass.
It's horrifically shitty.
I agree with you, Jacob. I completely agree with you. Bring that up.
What?
Dick Clark
trying to
Lee Corso. Yeah, because it was... I don't want to fucking go to Freak Bass's website.
Yeah, get out of here.
Why
this
are we
guy.
Looking at this shitty
I,
ass?
I thought you said bring that up as I looked into enter
hate
site.
Oh no. I don't want to see Freak Bass any more than I have to. Look at that. He just plays the bass too?
Ugh.
It's like a not cool Les Claypool.
Okay, so look up Dick
Clark. Are you horrified?
I'm mad at this guy. Look at him, dude. He's like trying to be.
We are Notre Dame. I bet he has a kid that's over 20. That's like, that's my fucking dad.
Oof.
What?
It's hard to be a part of.
What, that family?
I'd rather have, you know, the ordeal you went through.
Dead dad? Dude, if my dad was Freak Bass and he died, that'd be a large torch to carry.
You'd have to learn how to shred like Freak Bass. We are Notre Dame.
He's playing.
Oh, whoa, whoa.
The son of Freak Bass, Dan Bass, is here to play his father's signature song, We Are Notre Dame. We are Notre Dame. I like the Nuggets song better.
Nuggets song is significantly better.
And then the Sixers song is the best.
Sixers song is a genuinely good song.
I don't think it's genuinely a good
what?
Song.
Those lyrics?
I think it's a
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Sixers. 10, 9, 8, 76ers.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. How about that? What do you think of that, Jacob?
I'm still looking at Freak Bass and it's making me more and more angry. He looks like Feldog.
He's
Feldog
definitely from that ilk.
What's that?
He's definitely touched.
Yeah,
his
it's
youth.
Like it's Feldog caliber of music.
The only way you get into that is if you did get diddled.
Well, you got to get.
You end up, yeah.
You got to take a handy at least to make shit rock.
Next thing
like that.
You know, you're dressed like that.
You go, why am I wearing a band helmet and feathers? You go, oh yeah, got my dick sucked by that lifeguard when I was seven.
Goddamn guy.
Guy trapped me in the fucking swim buoy
Jesus
thing.
Jesus Christ.
It blew me like a son of a bitch. Didn't we get a fucking gift?
Got a nice painting. Yeah.
Oh, cool. Bring it down, thanks for bringing the heat on that one, Jacob.
Well, I wanted to bring it down.
With Jay?
With Jay.
Yeah, yeah. We'll reveal it with Jay. Sorry, Shane.
What was that?
You just got stepdadded.
I don't give a fuck, dude.
You and Jacob are going through something. Oh, man. Did you just show me stroke? Oh, fuck, Christine. Christine, how did you go right to this weird stroke kiss? It's 2012.
Is it Dick's final goodbye?
So. Damn.
Yeah, go to the beginning, though.
That was just a few days before Notre Dame got touched in the national title.
Was it?
2012 New Year's? Yeah.
Yeah, you can't hear him.
Oh my God, that's him talking?
Yeah.
Yes.
That's holy not really fuck. Him talking.
I swear to God, for
a second thought somebody took like the dog cartoon character and dubbed it over him.
Hey, dog.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody.
I thought somebody made a like fucking
welcome
video.
Back to American Bandstand. They go, Dick, no. Dick, no, you're stroking out. Welcome back. We got a band coming up. You're gonna look. Dude, that's fucking tough.
They brought out Betty White on something recently where she just looked out of sorts, and I was a little bit like, I don't know why they did that to her.
I feel like it's like interviewing fighters after they've been knocked out. You're like, just let them fucking go be old somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why you gotta bring them out and make them do the thing they did when they were young? Betty White's still around. She's got the Golden Girls title. Good for her.
Yeah, she's been with it for a really long time.
She had a whole show hot in Cleveland.
How old is she?
She's like in her 90s.
Yeah, I think.
Holding up nice.
Dude, Betty White.
Holding up real nice.
Yo, bring that video of that girl making, that old lady making out with that young guy.
Oh.
You want to see some hot gilf action?
I'm only looking for old sniz now.
Oh, dude, you told me. You told me you want fucking, you called it vacuum bags.
I love
you. You want it full of dust.
Yo, are you old sniz? Are you listening to this fucking episode right now?
Are you over 65?
Are you listening to radio? Probably.
Are you ready to fuck? 97 years old, Betty White.
97.
Damn, she was 20 during World War II. Yeah.
She was like fucking soldiers.
She was definitely fucking dudes from Normandy.
And they're coming back and they're going, Betty, come on. Come on, Betty.
Give me a fucking hand job.
Come on, Betty. I killed a bunch of krauts for you, baby.
That's her.
Oh,
is
nude.
That tits?
Yeah, she's hit a...
Are those tits?
Betty White?
Sweet tits.
Betty White did tits?
That's her during the war.
Dude, look at that. Wait, go in. I mean,
I'm trying to click on it. It's, there you go.
Yo.
Damn, she did tits for the troops?
Yeah, tits for troops. That was like a whole thing. She was smoking hot.
Yeah, she was smoking.
Holy moly.
Right? Flat butt, but that was the style then.
That was the style back then. That's about as thick as a fucking butt gets back then. That's pretty good. She's on fucking rations.
Yeah,
dude.
Usually
she's on World War II rations.
What are you eating? Fake meat? You having more tang? Get you in the factory. Get those rivets. Yeah. Look at this. Fucking go to the beginning of this. Watch this guy. We're going to tweet this video out. I want to say 40-year-old guy and a schlubby 65-year-old. And she's going for it. You can't hear him, but they go for a makeout. It's just,
oh
yeah, but watch him. Watch it. You can play the music. This is what's going on at the bar, and she's just whispering in his ear. And then you can tell he's like having fun, but then she goes for real action, and he's not having it. I didn't realize that there's absolutely no audio on this. See, he's like, oh fuck, right there. Oh fuck. What's the second so people can look at it?
That is
25 seconds.
Yeah, 25 in.
She just goes for it, and he's like, fuck.
Look, now he's back. Now he wants it.
Nice kiss in the side of her face. Look. Oh, she's kissing hard. Oh, look at him banging it around. Look at her. She's feeling things she hasn't felt in fucking 20, 25 years.
Cool. Adios míos.
Adios dable, me.
God damn.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. He's like, I want you so bad. You are like a little, you're like a loose ham. I hold you in my arms. You don't like this,
dude,
Jacob?
Oh, man, I can't look at that.
Come on.
I was DMing my Spanish mama last night, dude.
Your Spanish mama?
I fell in love with a lady in Spain.
You told me about that. When you were over there, a lot of people don't know this, though. Shane has another side where he goes and teaches children in foreign countries.
Yeah, I did teach English in Spain for a while.
Did you?
Yeah.
Back when I used to read
so
a lot of
Hemingway.
I used to read a lot of Hemingway, and I was like, I'm going to be a lot like Ernesto.
You do. You have like a Hemingway-like background where I go, you know that Shane was in a mild conflict in Chile? He calls it Chile. But
Chile. I had a girlfriend that lived in Chile, too.
What are you, just fucking around the world?
It was like, she got like fleas and shit. Chili's. Chili's a shithole, by the way.
Yeah.
Don't let them fool you with the brochures.
Yeah, I'm here to tell you.
Bit of a shithole.
You fuck a lady from Chile, you're going to get fucking.
Earthquakes, fleas. They just have dogs everywhere.
I had a teacher from Chile. She nice. Said that they used to eat guinea pigs. Or is that Peru? Peruvian?
Peru has a lot of guineas.
No, not guineas. Hey, what are you fucking eating me, hey. Bro?
Hey, I'm a fucking pig. Here.
Tommy Boy, Ginger Ninja says Tommy Boy.
Tommy Boy, good
yeah. Oh, great man. One, Ginger Ninja. If my kid watched that and didn't laugh,
you'd disown him.
Yeah. Or I'd just go, I always said the recipe for a great comic. If I had a kid, I'd just go get a gun, walk in the room, stare him right in the eyes, and just be like, be funny. Blow my brains out.
Do you think that's something you should be saying?
Out loud? I don't know. Do people want the recipe for greatness?
Yeah, he's like, true. Dad, I want to be a doctor.
Yeah. Well,
you're the comic.
Now you're going to be a real weird doctor.
Cool. Now you're going to do experiments on people. Probably in a basement.
Dr. Mengele.
Here, I'm going to turn you into a young Joseph Mengele. Yeah. Tommy Boy's a great one. Yeah. Dumb and Dumber, Tommy Boy.
Wayne's World for me.
Yeah. But I don't know if that holds up for a little kid.
I don't know if I loved it when I was a little kid.
It doesn't hold up. I just watched it. I just watched Wayne's World.
It has to.
It's fucking
rough.
But for
a kid?
Austin Powers holds up. Austin Powers 1.
Austin Powers is funny. I'm telling you.
So I Married an Axe Murderer holds up. I'll go through the whole Mike Myers
catalog. That's not kid. Yeah. Wayne's World's rough. That's more like teenager.
It's rough? I don't think
even for like a 9-year-old?
Maybe for a 9-year-old, but I just watched it. Yeah.
You're saying it was a rough watch.
Yeah.
I don't believe that.
I promise. I just did it.
All right. I'm going to watch Wayne's World.
Because I was introducing it to someone for the first time. Which might as well be a fucking 9-year-old. Well, and it was tough to
date
be like,
a 30-year-old.
No, this is funny. Hey, shut up over there.
Dude, he's going to date 65-year-olds now.
I am going to date 30-year-olds. I told you I was looking for ancient sniz.
Old dusty puss.
30 and up.
Dude, I can't wait for you to... You're like, hey, what's up? You guys show up. You show up to like the cellar and you're like, this is Edna. And she's like, hello.
Pleasure to meet you. I met Shane at Shuffleboard. He was so powerful.
He was so mean to everyone.
I said, you remind me of my Winston. He was a bully too. He got shot by the police. And then Shane said,
suicide by police. That's how he died.
And his brother told me it was to get away from me. Well, anyway, Shane puts me right back in that corner.
It's fucking breaking hips.
Would you fucking smash a geezer?
No.
Nothing you over smash a geese?
Over 50s. No.
Eventually you're going to.
All right.
Eventually.
Yeah, my wife, my lovely queen.
You think you're going to get old?
I don't get old, dude.
I don't think I'm getting old.
I'm going to replicate.
I think I'm going to be lucky to make it like 3 more years.
3 years?
So you need to make some changes then?
Yeah. Why didn't your voice go up right there?
Yeah, what the fuck is that supposed to mean?
I don't want to lose you in 3 years, Shane.
Just watch me fucking ride off into the sunset.
What does that even mean, though?
I don't know.
Just talk in analogies. You go, watch me flourish. What? How are you going to flourish? I don't know.
No, I don't
know. I don't know. Fiscally? Don't know.
Probably not fiscally.
You need to do drugs.
No. I'm going to start getting into drugs heavy and old sniz.
Old sniz? You think the old sniz?
Simultaneously.
You think the old sniz will pull you into drugs?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, she'll be like, I have Medicaid. Want to do some oxys and fuck?
Yes.
Let's take our first break. Shane Gillis hanging out while Jay films his new movie, Blade 4. I just want to see if we can get that trending. Yeah. They didn't make a Blade 4, right?
Probably.
No, they didn't.
I'll look it up.
Jay told me that they got Wesley Snipes for this one. He's doing his scenes with Wesley Snipes.
Oh, yeah.
Tomorrow.
This is the authentic number 4 that they're making.
Yeah. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. It's the goddamn bonfire.
My shit froze.
Yes! Hey, everybody. You heard us freeze right up. Oh, Blade 4. They did. God damn it. I was kidding around. Wait, no. Is this a fan-made?
Maybe it's fake.
I think this is fan-made. Because Jay's in Blade 4.
Yeah.
What is he filming right now? It's Blade 4. Are we still on the air? Or are we just...
Yeah.
Well, guess what, guys? If you're not wearing Mack Weldon underwear, you've been had. Stop buying underwear that doesn't fit right. That don't fit right and don't feel right. I see what it is. You know...
Sure that reads for us?
For what, the underwear? Dude, this is for sexy underwear. You don't tell the people that you wear Mack Weldon. You wear little boxer briefs.
Me?
Yeah. What do you wear? What kind of underwear do you wear?
Whitey tighties, dude.
Yeah. Dude, that's awesome. Mack Weldon, you should wear Mack Weldon. It's comfort. No more feeling sweaty. rolling waistbands, chafing, or riding up. They combine smart materials with smart designs like Pima cotton for maximum comfort. A ventilation panel. They even use real silver woven into the fabric that kills odors. Plus, it keeps you cool and comfortable all day. Hundreds of thousands of guys wearing Mack Weldon, and if you don't love your first pair, they'll pay for it. Buy them for someone you love. Buy them for yourself. Whatever you do, try Mack Weldon right now. Get Mack Weldon underwear today, and you'll save 20% with promo code BONFIRE. But only until the end of the month. Get 20% off at MackWeldon.com, promo code BONFIRE. MackWeldon.com, promo code BONFIRE. Is the system still broken?
No, we're
good, baby. Oh, so we just go to commercials now? Now that I look like an asshole? Dude, I'm in a real jealous Dan mode today. Jealous Jay.
What are you jealous about?
Just, you know, crew's not coming down on time. Everyone's being a little chippy.
Crew has been a real piece of shit today, to
Thank
be
you.
Honest.
Thank
I've
you,
noticed
Shane.
It big time. Jacob's been giving me nothing but attitude.
You know what it is? Is Jacob soaking in puss.
Yeah, he's laying in a baby pool of sniz right
yeah.
now. He's
been, yeah, and then now he's just like, you're right. It's the big dick confidence.
What's up with you, bro? I heard about what you were up to down in Austin.
What's up with you two?
Were you kissing girls?
He kissed a lady.
Yeah.
On her face.
What do you think's wrong with me, dude?
You're a little upset, aren't you?
You don't like that?
Why would I not like that? Or why would I like that, dude? I want you to be mine. I want that fucking cherry ripe when I pop that fucking, when I break you off, dude.
Oh,
when
dude.
I pop in that butt.
Will you genuine him?
I'm going to send a group text to everybody and be like, oh, Jacob's fucking women's soccer party is canceled, and I'm going to come over and fucking uncork one in. I'm going to save up for a week. Be coming out of your nose, dude. Fill you up, kid.
Yeah, dude. Give him the Twinkie. Make him all cream on the inside. Yeah, I love it.
Normally, he's happy to see me. He made out with a couple chicks. You finger? Yeah. You finger down Texas? No. Do the old Texas two-step?
Dude. Uh-huh. Little digit dance? Huh?
You didn't finger anyone?
I was invited to go two-stepping, though. I'm going to do it.
Are you excited about that? Yeah, you got to get boots, though.
Like Texas two-stepping or like a Crip blood type thing?
You're going to rep his set.
Was it a blood?
What up, Marky-ass Busters? It's Jacob Batat.
Hey, you Marky-ass Busters.
Hey, what's up, everybody? You guys know any slobs coming around the way? Repping 236. Gang.
Oh. Dude, if Jacob just started sea-walking hard. All right.
So what's going on with the ladies?
I mean, that's it right now. Yeah.
Just making it. You made out a little bit. Now you feel any tits? You feel any tits over the shirt tits?
That's a good question. That wasn't
over
asked.
The shirt tits on, during a makeout.
I love it. I love
pretty
a
much
a
mandatory.
I'll do even in
a quick squeeze. Keep
butt
it
grab.
Butt grab. Faux
butt
show.
Grab. I would probably say is the number one step in a makeout. You go for butt grab.
I go
first.
Butt grab
before boobs. Boobs second.
Yeah.
You go butt grab first.
See what's going on.
Grab second.
See what? Hey, are we allowed to grab the butt?
What if there's hip push into you? You're like, yeah.
Oh, then I'm gonna over the pants finger you for sure.
Too low clip.
Give a fucking pat. Give a pat. Kick the tires.
I was gonna say check the undercarriage. Yeah, that's good to go.
I kick the tires. I'll
there
fucking,
she is.
What's this?
Where are you? What are you riding with?
Huh?
What you packing in here?
It's a PSI on this thing. Huh?
Huh? Yes. You ready to shoot?
I'm gonna fucking shoot.
Jay was mocking my over the pants hand jobs, but those
over the pants hand jobs are the fucking best. Man.
Thank you. What? I really felt like I was alone in here. No one fucking stood up for me.
That gets me going.
Over the PHJs?
I almost require an over the pants hand job.
Yeah, dude.
Almost every makeout.
Dude, it's just like, it's like priming a lawnmower.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like,
especially you just rub the top of it because it's against your pants.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude,
it's nice.
All right.
Yeah. Well, see? Come on.
Cooking with gas.
That's why we hang out.
What's going on?
That's why we hang out.
Jacob, you got to start getting more over-the-pants hand jobs. Embrace it.
Oh, dude, I'm with you on that.
Oh, yeah, you fucking jizzed your pants that one
time. Nobody got to that part. I didn't even get up that high.
Oh, man. You know what's crazy is if she listens to the show, do you think she knows? Do you think she heard that story? Oh, thank God.
No.
Yeah, that's a tough one for a lady.
Do you think she listens?
No.
Good. All right. But her friend does.
Are you sure about that?
Oh, well... You mean the one the...
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
He forgets these hoes, dude.
No, I thought you meant the girl who I had that experience with in...
Oh.
What experience with?
Pants,
when he cummed it, when he came in his pants.
Got overexcited.
That's what you call it? That was an experience?
Yeah, he goes, I just had an experience.
I don't like to...
Sorry, I experienced
it. It's hard for me to say out loud.
Yeah, I
why?
Get it.
Overexcited.
But there's nothing wrong with that.
What, coming in your pants?
Just a pre-jack? A hard...
It wasn't a pre-jack. I think it was full nut.
Full semen?
It was so long ago.
I feel like it was a few months ago.
It was less than a year ago.
It was so long. It's like another lifetime.
But look at that. In less than a year, how much Jacob's rebounded. He's gone from just painting up jeans to just making out and digit dancing down in Texas. Just give it a nice puzzle slap over the jeans.
What is this? Hey, lady, what the fuck is this?
What do you got? It's such a funny jaw underbite fucking talk.
What is this? What is this?
Is this mine? Is this about to be mine? Is this Jacob's twat?
Is this
Jacob's patwat?
Is this where I play? Is this where I play?
Am I about to set up shop in here?
Huh?
Huh?
Base camp. Base camp.
I'm about to fucking climb in there. This is base camp, lady.
Slap her pussy.
I'm gonna get a Sherpa to guide me up in here.
You know what my Sherpa is? My dick. Yeah, you ready for the Sherpa? Base camp.
This is my Sherpa. Yeah.
Right. We're going to take our first break. Shane Gillis hanging out. It's the bonfire. Oh, yeah. It's time for spring cleaning. And Quip's got an easy way to start with your brushing habits, and now the whole family can get refreshed with Quip. The new Kids Quip has the same 2-minute timer and guiding pulses like our original version with no childish gimmicks, so they can brush just like a grown up. The new brush, all right, I can only do that. I only had a little bit in that for me, but you know, I just get real pumped talking about the Quip for kids. The new brush, same as our original version, just tweaked for downsized mouths. Kids will be inspired to brush better and more often with oral care products that look and feel like what adults use. Little ones will love the kid-friendly features like a small brush.
For what?
A small brush head, watermelon anti-cavity toothpaste, and colorful rubber grip handles. Help them develop a grown-up routine. Quip's sensitive sonic vibrations boast an effective clean that's gentle on sensitive gums.
You gotta help them develop a grown-up routine.
Yep, the built-in 2-minute timer pulses every 30 seconds to remind you when to switch sides.
It helps you.
Yep, it pulses and it cleans your whole
mouth.
Yep, your whole clean mouth evenly. That's why I love Quip and why over a million happy, healthy mouths do too. Quip just starts at $25, and if you go to getquip.com/bonfire right now, you can get your first refill pack for free. That's your first refill pack free at getquip.com/bonfire. Get me out of here. What? I got to get out of here.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
That's right.
Jack Gillis, by the way.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
That's his government name?
Fairly certain.
That's pretty badass.
Yeah.
That's actually really badass. It's the Bonfire Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. Big Jay Oakerson out filming Blade 4, sitting in for him. Philadelphia's own, specifically Mechanicsburg.
So. Mechanicsburg, PA, baby. Let's get it.
By way of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Shane the Bull Gillis.
Sheets Nation, we out you.
Jack Gillis, spelled exactly the same, dude.
Yeah, me and that pale monster.
Oh, you mean that genius? That musical genius?
Yeah.
You guys do have some pasty-ass skin, though.
Hell yeah.
More of a pink tint.
I'm more pink. I think he's like wearing like makeup.
Yeah, you got a pink tint.
I'm very pink. Almost red.
You're like a peach.
I'm almost...
You're like a beet red. Beet old red.
I'm gonna let it go.
Come on, man. By the way, facial hair coming in. Pristine.
Facial hair is gonna be a problem.
Yeah, you got some stuff coming up. We're gonna
film another that tires etc. thing,
which you should go check out.
You can check it on YouTube. If you just type in tires pilot, it'll be on there. It's pretty cool. We're filming another one, but I lost that bet to Jay in 2K because he cheated, and now I have.
He didn't cheat.
He did cheat.
He didn't cheat.
I don't understand video games.
I understand that my boyfriend didn't cheat.
He did cheat.
I wish you guys could have seen Shane's face.
Said it to All Pro.
When Christine stood up for Jay.
Christine has been standing up for him against me.
But you know what's funny is Jay usually thinks that Christine is the first person to turn her and shits on her, but she's battling for her man that he didn't cheat.
Every time I've talked shit, she's been quick to tell me to shut up.
This is a prime.
He's not here.
Yeah.
You've been a real talk shit to his face. You've been a real jerk to me.
Yeah.
I think you're a jerk.
I think you're... Oh, yeah. I wasn't even trying to do that. That's great. The facial hair is starting to...
So what do you want to...
It's going to be a problem.
So what do you think?
Well, I got that, and then, I got some other things coming up.
You got some stuff coming up that I don't really know if you should have fucked up facial hair for
I can't have fucked up facial hair for this.
Are you asking in some way?
All right. We'll forget that he cheated.
He didn't cheat.
All right.
I was there. I watched
the whole
game.
He didn't cheat.
The whole game's on
Instagram.
Let's
just say he didn't cheat.
He didn't cheat.
You just suck at the game.
For the sake of this argument.
You didn't grow up with it.
Black Lou.
You didn't play.
Black Lou beat him in Austin.
In practice.
Black Lou.
For the sake of this, we'll just say he didn't cheat.
Does Jay cheat?
No, he doesn't cheat.
He didn't cheat, right?
He doesn't cheat.
He doesn't actually cheat, but does he cheat?
He's just better.
A little bit. You hear that?
He didn't say.
He puts it on all pro.
Yeah.
Or he puts it on all star, and then he doesn't play defense. What?
He plays defense?
What does that mean?
He lets... You don't know. It means he lets the computer
Big
play
Jay
defense.
Jay Oakerson is not a cheater.
Yeah. Big Jay's a fucking cheater, and Blade 4 is going to fucking suck.
Stop it. Wesley Snipes would never sign on to something that
and
doesn't work.
Jacob fucking pulsed in his pants.
Pulsed is such a great word for coming.
Yeah, dude.
Where did you come up with pulse? I've never heard that. Just pulsed in my pants? Uh-oh, I'm about to pulse.
I'm about to fucking pulse every 30 seconds.
Uh-oh. Pop, 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 pop.
I'm going to fucking pulse this.
I'm pulsing all over it.
Hold on, I'm about to pulse.
I'm pulsing in my pants.
You feel that? I just pulsed.
What a great album title for Jacob the Tot, Pulsing in My Pants.
just pulsing with Jacob.
He pulsing in his pants. Just him in tight, like Bruce Springsteen-like jeans. Just half cock on the side.
But yeah,
Jay
did
not cheat. He
Jay
beat
obviously
you.
Didn't fucking cheat.
He slammed. He beat
Look,
you in the beer
I knew,
game.
I went into it saying I was gonna lose.
Sure.
I just wanted to take the off chance that he actually had to shave his beard.
Yes,
but
he didn't. But you had to grow yours. For
I have
4 weeks,
to grow out mine,
and you have two very important things in the next 4 weeks.
Yeah.
So you are looking to barter.
I'm just saying, maybe we can.
What do you want to do? Let me speak.
I don't know
for,
if
I'm speaking as Jay's legal counsel in this. I can't speak for Jay, but I can take what you tell me and try to broker.
No,
a deal.
We don't need a picture of this right now. I see you moving over there.
And if we're going to take a picture of it, make sure you get better light. He doesn't get this stoner fucking.
After the show, I'll give you a nice.
Here's
the
thing, and I'm going to be honest with you because you know I love you. Mustache is pretty good.
Mustache is great.
Pretty good. It's not great. It's
mustache
good.
Is borderline elite.
It's not
at all. A lot of people are excited about
you
it.
You look like a French farmer, like a fucking rural French farmer.
A lot of people have been asking me, what's the secret
to
what
your
are you
fromage?
Doing with that mustache?
To your fromage?
For sure.
Monsieur, c'est le fromage. The Saint-Gilles is one of the greatest cheese farmers Eastern France has ever seen. Here's what I can probably work out if you want to talk deals.
Yeah, dude.
If you're willing to talk to us.
I mean, I did lose the fucking bet.
Sure, you're guilty. We got you on the charges.
I can't welch on this. I'm not going to. There was a part of me that was
so
just like,
I'm
I should just shave it and say, fuck
no.
them.
You do that, you're going to do way more damage to your long-term record.
Yeah.
Here's what I'm willing to give you a plea deal. I'm willing to go to Jay and ask him to let you shave side, face, and neck.
Yes.
You leave the mustache Please. And the bottom tee. You
please,
gotta leave mustache
please.
And
the
bottom
side
teeth.
Of the neck are just terrible.
It is it's an abomination.
It's like one hair every square inch.
It looks like the back of my calf.
Oh,
I don't
really
have hair
does.
On my calf.
It's like,
it looks like how you grow hair on your calf. Yeah,
and it's like there's like red marks now and shit and irritation. It's
so what
so
I'm
bad.
Gonna do is I'm gonna review your case. I'm gonna bring it to Jay. Again, he's on set at Blade 4. He's probably
he's
helping.
Any time.
He's helping Wesley Snipes kill a shit ton of zombies.
So you want me to keep the Guy Fawkes mask?
Yes, you're going to keep V for Vendetta. You look like a V for Vendetta ate at Sheets. remember that Sheets Nation is the best. Yeah, all right. I think we can work that out. Do you think that's fair, Christine?
No, I think you should have to grow the beard.
Fucking Christine's been on my ass.
She's unforgiving.
God
unwavering.
Damn. All right, I'll keep this if you don't shave your feet.
No way. My feet are getting shaved.
I'll
my mustache
in,
is getting threaded.
I'll play you in 2K for feet hair.
You want a face?
Why would I take that bet?
You want a face feet game? You have to do share knowledge.
I'll shave my eyebrows if you win.
There's no way.
God damn it.
I like
you know
what'd be great? I don't even care.
Second half if she just gave the controller to Jay. Fucking came back and dominated. I might be able to talk Jay into
talk to him.
I
talk
can't
to
promise
your boy,
you.
Dude. Well, talk to your fucking boy.
You're gonna have to watch your tone, bud. You're gonna have to watch your tone. because you're asking
Jacob,
very
do something,
thing.
Dude.
You're asking a Welch on a bet.
I'm not welching.
You're trying to.
I'm asking. That's not welching. I'm throwing just myself at your fucking hairy
feet.
I say throw out.
I say, Christine, throw out a survey at the Bonfire SXM.
No, don't give it to the people. They'll all say no.
It's a democracy, Shane. And ask them if it's worthy of a plea bargain. Should Shane get facial hair probation or house arrest, basically? Is Shane worthy of a facial hair plea bargain?
If we show them what this looks like in one more week...
Yeah, you got a fucking camera right there.
They're going to say, you got to...
Here, you know what?
Can't really...
Get in there. At the Bonfire SXM on Instagram. We'll put up an Insta story of what it looks like.
Oof.
Well, come on. I'm willing to make the plea. But Jacob, what do you think? You're his lover, his friend.
No,
he likes it. He likes feeling it. He likes feeling the beard.
He's got
full beard
all over his back.
Are you? You're a full beard guy now. You look great with the beard.
When I collapse after I pulse.
After I pulse up into my chest beard.
When Jacob and I collapse and
into
post coitus.
Too humble, but too humble.
I humble
bodies.
His butt, dude.
What a great way to talk about butt fucking. I'm going to humble your butt.
Your butt is real arrogant.
Isn't that what the Iron Sheik always says? I humble you. I butt fuck you.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah. Jacob, do you think he's worthy of a plea bargain?
No, I think he lost. He lost the bet. He's going to grow the beard.
This is a tough. He's giving you such
a
bitch face.
He's trying to plea deal to a goatee. I just want to make sure I have this right.
Yeah, he's trying to plea deal.
Well, I also don't want people to think I'm trying.
You are.
To shave the other side.
Oh, it's just the cheeks and the neck are rough, man.
And then, dude, getting on the subway and shit.
Not easy.
Yeah.
It's not easy.
Especially the way I'm already wearing a sweatsuit.
Yeah. But, you know, maybe Jay will find some leniency. Maybe the people will find some leniency. This room seems to have none. This room seems to be very
even
firm.
You, dude. E2, Jacob.
E2,
Boutte. Stab me in the back.
That's right.
Whatever. Fuck it.
Just goes, that's right.
That's right.
That's right. That's right.
God damn. Some dude goes down to Texas, gets some sniz, comes back up.
Comes back smelling like masculine. He's just masculine.
Yeah, no, fuck it. No, I'll keep it.
All right. Well, we'll see what the people say. Maybe you got a way out of here. I'm saying, let's say you're keeping it. And then we'll see what the people say.
The people.
Should we keep this going one day?
Yeah. People are not going to. No one will have mercy.
I wouldn't. You know that, man.
I wouldn't.
You wouldn't?
Do you hear that, listener? Any of you, I want the worst things to happen for you.
I don't know. That's a good word. That's a good way to plead your case. I don't think that's what you're supposed to do. That's like when
I don't know how to do this, dude.
You know, that's like when they execute someone and they say something for the last time and they're like, fuck you, I did it. Fucking pieces of shit.
There was one dude whose last words were, go Raiders. Got anything to say? He was like, go Raiders.
That's so great.
Kill him.
Just fucking end that one. Just zap him. Well, we always do depressing dog stories when you come on.
Yeah.
You know, there was the dog getting hit by the car. There was Pippa No.
R.I.P. Finnegan. Shout out Riggins.
Now you can do a whole segment about people who could beat up Jay. What did Sarah McPants tweet out?
I was talking about Jay getting his ass beat by people.
Jay can't. When were we talking about Jay getting his ass beat?
I mean, Collinsworth would fucking lay him out. Who else? There's a ton of people.
Chris Collinsworth, if Jay shot on him, if he got a double leg takedown.
Jay's not here. Obviously, he would fucking give Collinsworth the fucking business.
Yeah.
He would fucking maul him.
Chris Collinsworth is an old man. He's an old man now. Oh, back to the depressing dog story. So we saw this. Black Lou sent this one over, and it's just a question of who you are as a person, because I think there would be certain people that would do the same thing, but I don't think I would. Caroline Bittencourt, who is a Victoria's Secret model, drowned trying to save her dogs. She was boating with her husband and they hit a storm and her dogs fell off the sailboat and then she tried to jump in. It was in Sao Paulo, Brazil. Caroline was on a catamaran with her husband Jorge Centini and their two dogs. While out at sea, a huge storm with reported winds over 60 miles an hour rocked the boat and knocked the pooches off the catamaran into the rough water. Is this them running with her?
Yeah.
She died for those types of dogs?
Yeah, right? A Labrador, I get it. I'll fucking go in the ice for a fucking golden retriever. Yeah. Frozen Lake, If my fucking Rottweiler, if I got a real Rottweiler.
A real Rottweiler, boy.
A Rottweiler. Going through the ice, I fucking jump in. I jump in and I fucking grab his muscular body and I pull him out.
Why do you do what?
Rottweilers are jacked, dude. That's why I like him. I want to fuck a Rottweiler. I go all the way there without you saying a thing. You know, what? Is it the way I say, oh, I want to fuck a
I'll fucking let one have me.
A stubby-tailed little monster. Play that video again. She's smoking hot. R.I.P.
Send me some on the video.
Yeah. Oh. Damn.
Watch it again.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Nothing bad will ever happen to these dogs.
Like, ooh. Outside my window, I see
fields so snow. Well,
is this a video made for them?
This was just a video on her Instagram account before it happened of her with her dogs. It's from 2017.
Yeah, this isn't as funny as I thought it'd be.
Yo, man, do you jump in for your dog?
Hell yeah.
60 mile an hour winds.
Please, dude.
Worth leaving.
I'm buoyant.
I mean, Jesus.
Can I bring up something? The husband jumped in to rescue her.
Yeah.
And I was thinking...
Do you let her go? Is it what you're saying, let her go? He goes, I don't know. Can I get another Victoria's Secret?
I got to jump because I'm never going to hear the end of it.
Oh, man. I didn't think of that. She gets some real fucking, you guys are on that, you're on the Coast Guard boat in a fucking thick green blanket. And she goes, you just didn't want to jump? He's like, I mean, I was renting the catamaran. I had to get it back. The deposits on these things are like fucking 10,000.
Oh, man. What a...
He jumped. Hours later.
What's that?
He was rescued hours later.
Yeah, a few hours later. Oh, and she washed up on a beach Monday. Oh, God. And they have a 17-year-old kid.
Who found her?
I don't know.
We got to interview that fisherman.
He's like, I got a mermaid.
When did you find her?
He goes, I find a lady of the sea. To some Brazilian fisherman. I got the biggest fish I ever caught. Oh, my God. It's a beautiful woman. What has happened? A beautiful woman has washed up on my beach. Yeah, dude, that's fucked up. Dogs go and then you go. I don't think I go in for dogs that small.
Yeah, those shitty dogs, little tiny dogs. Like, bah,
bah, bah, and then they're gone and you're like, meh.
Yeah, that's Pippa.
Yeah, Pippa, no! Pippa, whatever.
Yeah,
it's real Pippa, whatever.
Swine.
Ah. No. Yeah, you don't go after the gator. That guy was like, get back here, gator!
Yeah, you just are like, well.
You ain't my Pippa! Yeah, you just let it go.
That should have been exactly what they said.
Yeah,
on
she
the
should
boat.
Have been like, oh, no. But a Brazilian, she should have been like, oh no,
oh, no,
no.
Brazilian's real ugly language. It's Portuguese.
Portuguese.
Yeah, it's real fucking like. That's actually probably what her last words were.
you're getting. Oh, Jacob, come on. It was a little funny. You're just getting smoked on this fucking.
Yeah, obviously, dude. No. Christine, are you the one who fucking worded this?
Yeah.
No, he made his bed.
The tweet at the Bonfire SXM said, should Shane Gillis be able to get a plea deal from his NBA 2K bet with Big J to only keep his goatee or nah? 16% yes, goatee. 84% no, he made his
look,
bet.
Look, dude, this is like CNN versus Trump. Early, they were like, 16% chance he wins.
Yeah. So you're saying you're going to pull this off?
Yeah. The true cameras.
Am I your Steve Bannon?
Yeah, dude, fan it out.
Just get bad skin and grow my hair
up. Fire it up.
Man, make it look like old pepperoni pizza that's cold on your face.
Yeah, I got no shot of winning this one.
Yeah, well.
I don't want to. You know what? I went into this mercy, but fuck that. Fuck you guys.
Why yeah?
Do you think you're
my facial. I don't think
I'm getting it. What's wrong with you?
No, I really didn't expect that.
No.
Obviously, my facial. First off, my facial hair is fucking cool.
Fuck.
What's wrong? We got
nothing. I'm so upset that you don't want to go through this. Dude, listen, man, I'm going through a lot. And when you're selling online, getting your orders out can be a real pain. I didn't have a natural transition. I have no natural transition. It's time-consuming and expensive. And how do you know you're making the best choice? That's why you need ShipStation.com, the fastest, easiest, and most affordable way to manage and ship your orders. ShipStation helps you get orders out quickly and save money on shipping costs. Shane's just talking trash to Christine. No matter where you're selling, ShipStation brings all your orders into one simple interface. ShipStation will recommend the best shipping carrier for each for each order based on the specific needs at the lowest rates available. You can compare rates all across the top carriers and always know that you're getting the best deal. They even offer discounts on shipping costs. No wonder ShipStation's the number one choice online for online sellers. You know, when you do a read for the first time, you're really like, I should probably read this before, because I'm just like cutting off sentences halfway, and then I'm like, eh, it keeps going, you know? Well, ShipStation never cuts off. You'll ship more in less time with the best rates available. Right now, try ShipStation free for 60 days by using the promo code Bonfire. There's no credit card required to try it out, so why wait? Go to ShipStation.com, click on the microphone at the top of the homepage, and type in Bonfire. That's ShipStation.com. Enter Bonfire, ShipStation. Make ship happen. It was a little late. It was dangerously late. It was contractually not obligated late, but we're fine. We're doing radio. We're having fun. Shane's on his phone. He's here. He's involved. Where were you?
I thought
I needed you right there.
Oh, really?
You know where Jay is every time I come out of a read? There to catch me. You know where you were? Tweeting old puss, just trying to get some 65-year-old muff.
Puss.
And I'm getting real fucking sick of it, Shane.
Look, man, I wouldn't come up here if I knew all of you were going to turn on me. Did anybody else have anything to say?
What, are you turning on me like Vinny Brand turned on Pete Davidson? Segway. 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 With Dan Soder. Welcome back to Segway. Pete Davidson walked out of a gig yesterday at the Stress Factory in Connecticut, the second Stress Factory owned by Vinny Brand. Pete left. I saw it on his Insta story. Shane and I were coming home from the cellar. I showed you it. And he was like, all right, I got to cancel my show. Vinny Brand is a dickhead. So I immediately texted Pete. I was like, what do you what happened? And he's like, he went on stage and said shit about me, and I told him not to, and he fucking did, so I left. That's literally the phone call.
Wild.
And I was like, all right, what did he say? And apparently Shane was like, hey, Vinny, or Shane, Pete was like, hey, Vinny, don't go on stage and do time. Like, I don't want you going on and doing time. And Vinny Brand was like, all right, well, I'm going to go make an announcement. It's my club, and I'm going to say this. So he was like bringing people up. It was Derek Gaines and Ricky Velez, and they had a couple other people. And so I guess he went on stage and he was about to, you know, bring Pete, and Pete, he was like, don't. Vinny was like, don't, you know, don't bring up Ariana Grande or Kate Beckinsale or whoever this kid's fucking, I think was the line that he had.
Oh, God.
You know, and Pete was like, I told you not to say shit. And so he left. He just dipped out, and then he put up an Insta story saying he would honor the tickets at another free show. Here it is.
Sorry that we had to leave the show before I got to go on. The owner, Vinny Brand, disrespected me and did something that I told him not to do. And I can't, you know, perform under those circumstances. However.
Yeah, hope maybe when this thing pans out, we'll get Pete on the show. Pete's still yet to come on the show, which is crazy. But yeah, he left. And then Vinny Brand, I didn't see this video, but Vinny Brand went on stage and started talking shit.
Yeah, and it's about 2 minutes, and it's just really like a rallying against Pete.
Oh, he sucks! I'm happy because I know I can do his voice. So I'm like, fucking, let's do it. Let's dance. Ooh, spring refresh for less. Oprah. You devil.
Knickknacks.
Love knickknacks. Pier 1 Emporium.
Remember when we went knickknack shopping?
Uh-oh.
Yeah, we had fun.
Remember when we got along?
Yeah.
Stop, Shane.
Before you lost.
Oh, wow. Here it is.
Something that I told him not to do.
Oh, he played the video. He played the Insta story at the club.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's a little.
Oh, dude, that's so. Wait, pause it real quick. That's so funny that you're like standing there. And you're like, you want to see what kind of piece of shit he is? And he's like, free show later. He goes, fuck.
Don't go to that. No, he literally, I think at the end of it, he's like, don't go to that fucking show.
Yo, dude, that's so funny. Like,
we're going.
He's the famous guy that they're there to see. And he's like, what a dick, right? Free show. Ooh, that's good. It's really coming out of pocket for that one. Fuck. He's going to take a 15K hit on a Tuesday for that. The bass is fucking loud. Damn, Vinny.
Get your Facebooks out.
And let me know when you're live, and I'll do it right now.
Let's go. Oh, whoa. Oh, fuck.
Fuck it. We'll do it live.
Fuck it. We'll do it live. This thing fucking sucks. What does that mean? What does that mean, play you out? What does that mean? Fuck it. We'll do it live. Dude, he's going full fucking, oh, I want him to see this. Dude, that's kind of, I'll tell you this, man. It's, you know, you don't really know, like, what transpired on both ends, because there could, you know, there could be stuff that we have no clue had happened. But I'll tell you this, it's not good to fucking go down this road where you're just like, open up your phones. I'm going to get nuts. I caught one of his friends.
Fucking watch this.
We're going to kill him.
Watch this shit. Put it on the internet.
Yeah, yeah. You don't want to do that. You don't want to have the fervor of an ISIS member being like, put this on. We kill him. We kill for him. Hit play.
For all my patrons here at the show's back.
Patrons.
On no way in the world would I ever disrespect any comedian. And if you look at the wall of the Stress Factory, you will see bona fide superstars that have worked for us for years. D.L. Hughley, John Leguizamo, Andrew Dice Clay, Chris Rock. The
Pause it. So funny that you're hitting all these names with like these millennials that are like 19 and love Pete, and they're like, "Yeah, it's Andrew Dice Clay. I don't know if you, Jonathan Winters." He's just naming people that no one knows. That they're like, "What?"
Yeah, Andrew Dice Clay. That you millennials definitely wouldn't be fucking triggered by.
Oh my god, are you kidding me? If they saw Dice in 88, they'd be like, why does he say all those rape stuff mean things? That's how you break them to show them Dice.
You dumb bimbos.
You stupid.
I'm
eating this girl's ass. Dude, the best is when they pan over, she's just putting on lip gloss. Go back like 3 seconds. Vinny's like, I would never do that. He's giving his Mr. Smith goes to Washington, and this girl's just like, what's that? Pete's not here. Do we leave now? I don't know. Do we leave? Right, look. Is she eating? Oh, she's taking out a mozzarella stick. That's even better.
Oh, my God.
Is she?
You got it right. Just getting those Burt's Bees.
And Pete Davidson, I didn't disrespect you. Your security guy told me to say what I said. And if you
dude, this is... It's great. It's almost wrestling promo style. And listen here, Pete Davidson. If you got your phone open, I've been coming down a long road.
I wonder if the security guy really did tell him to say that.
Dude, and he's like this. Right now, he's like,
he's just looking at Pete to be like, is that funny? Pete freaks out. He's like, oh, fuck.
Ooh. He's about to be like this. Yo, my dude, I got you, huh? Yeah. Fucking tricked you.
Vinny's not taking responsibility for being a little bit of a dickhead here, because it's like he probably was nudging, and the security guard probably said, like, don't tell the crowd not to mention his ex-girlfriend's, like, don't heckle, and he went in with, like, a tinge of, like, and Vinny's a prankster. Like, Vinny likes to goof around. He, prank like, plays phone
calls.
Jokes.
During
like
the show, he does prank phone calls. Which is a weird way to be, like, you do a prank and it turns. He's like, hey, this next guy, I don't know who he's fucking. Who's he fucking? Everyone? And he's like, he's gone? He left.
Oh, shit.
Fuck.
I'm
surprised. Really? When did he leave? Now?
Just left.
Fuck. Like right now. He walked out. Is
get
he in the car?
Get your Facebook's out.
Get your Facebook it out.
I'm going to fucking go nuts.
Oh fuck. I'm going to go anti-Jew.
Are there any Jews here?
Stop.
Did the Jews do this to me again?
He just spirals in a weird way. I'll tell you who it is. It's the lizard people. That's why Pete has those tattoos. They cover up his scales. He's a lizard man. Hit play, because he's going nuts.
You should have fired your goddamn security guard. You shit on everybody here. You shit on everybody here, Pete.
I didn't get a crowd behind him.
You came, you hung out in my club in New Brunswick. We treated you well. When you were having trouble last year, I texted you multiple times. Pete, if you need to talk to anybody, reach out. I tried so hard. And I went back in that room.
The way, the way his shirt's riding up on the back, it looks like he's like wired up to be taken off into the rafters. He's gonna fly away.
He looks stage wired. Yeah. Where he goes, and another thing.
He's like, what more?
Here,
thing?
You
can
believe.
Fly, pussy.
He goes, I've learned the ability of flight. Yeah, dude, it really does look like at any moment he's like, go away. He just goes over the audience. Yo, Pete Davidson didn't come out, but this old white dude flew.
He flew it, dude.
Fucking nuts. It was nuts.
Vinny Brand is God.
Yeah, dude. He got so angry, he flew. He was so disrespected. Yeah, just keep.
You were not disrespected, but you disrespected the board, which is fucking impossible.
He's still going? It looks like a giant, it looks like a cut that went like 40 minutes. He's like, this guy's doing 50 on why he hates Pete.
I respect you a lot.
Okay.
Better reputation gets better and better, right? And then this fucking asshole gets the hair across his cunt because he can't get his wife.
Having a meltdown. talking about celebrity big timing him.
Yeah, dude, for real. For real. And that was that's a Marsha like, meltdown.
I text Pete too. He also didn't get back to me. Yeah. I text, you know.
Yeah, dude. I mean, it's, I don't know, man. That would be really funny if it was the driver. And he goes, so, yo, that wasn't funny. He goes, and Vinny's like, what do you want me to say? He goes, yo, you should say
that. Definitely
like,
make fun of him for his past relationships.
You should be like this. You should be like, no phones. And he fucked like Ariana Grande, came back to say, be like, yo, he stretched them all out. That's hilarious. Yo, you gonna say that? That's hilarious.
This is gonna be great. Pete, watch this.
Yo, Pete, he's saying it now. He goes, all right, so this next guy fucked Ariana Grande, came back and said, he's gone. He's gone.
Pretty good, right?
He's gone. Is that door shutting? I got a refund. Does he have to refund? What's the deal with that? He doesn't have to pay Pete.
No, he doesn't have to pay Pete.
Keep the money? What a weird... I'm bad with business.
He'd probably try to offer free tickets to another show before he offered a refund.
It's always some asshole like me. Yeah. Come see Dan Soder. She's never played the room before. Do you like Billions? Do you guys like Guy Code? Pete and I worked together at Stress Factory when we were both on Guy Code, and Vinny Brand tried to turn it into a Guy Code weekend, and I was like, don't do that. Don't do that. Like the flyers came out, and I was like, I had to tell my old agent, I was like, you fucking reach out to them. It is not a Guy Code weekend.
It's Guy Code weekend. I love Guy Code weekends. Yeah.
You fucking, because you keep a Guy Code.
Saturdays are for the Guy Codes, dude.
Yeah, Saturdays, Man Cave.
I love Man Cave.
I forgot. We saw the Chive.
I love beating off in recliners.
Jay and I did a interview with Chive, and I forgot to bring you up that you're always promoting them.
I love the Chive.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. That's Barstool. They invented Barstool.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Let's take another break. Shane Gillis hanging out all day. It's already fucking 7:20.
Wow.
So many videos to get to. So much SEX to talk about.
We're talking sex?
Maybe. I don't know. Talking old sex.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's the bonfire. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, fire sound made it sound weird. This Mother's Day, team up with Boll & Branch to give the moms in your life the gift of better sleep. The folks at Boll & Branch.
I'll put them out. Give them a good night's sleep.
Why don't we bring old Shane Boll to your mom's house? The folks at Boll & Branch think nothing. This is the worst read for sheets on Mother's Day, and it's our show. You're like, this is just the perfect storm. Jacob, don't worry. We're going to get through it. We're all going to get through it because Boll & Branch has 100% pure organic cotton sheets. Hundreds of thousands of Americans sleep better thanks to Boll & Branch. They're the only sheets loved by 3 U.S. presidents. Your boy loves them.
Really?
Oh, talks about them all the time. Every product is designed with you in mind. From their signature soft sheets to their cozy throws to their plush towels. And they want you to love their Boll & Branch purchase. So they give you a 30-day risk-free trial, whether you're giving them as a gift or try them yourself. Now is the perfect time to get Boll & Branch for a limited time. You can save $50 off your first set of sheets. That's B-O-L-L and branch.com, promo code bonfire for $50 off your first set of sheets. BollandBranch.com, promo code bonfire.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Jack White Day on the bonfire. So we're doing Rock on Tours, Your Blue Veins. It is the bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I am Dan Soder, Big J. Okerson, out on a movie set, Hollywood Okerson. Sitting in for him, the Bull, Shane Gillis, from Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast. Make sure you go check out that. Go download it. Also go to cc.com/bonfire and check out the new bonfire website. In Columbus, Ohio, this Friday and Saturday, Big J is going to be at the Funny Bone. So make sure you get tickets if you're in the Ohio area. And then the big weekend, May 16th to the 19th, Big J going to be at Caroline's on Broadway. So if you want to see Big J in the city, at one of the most historic comedy clubs in the city, May 16th through the 19th, BigJComedy.com for tickets. I will be in Calgary, Alberta, Canada at the Laugh Shop, May 9th through 11th. And then Comedy Connection in Rhode Island, May 17th and 18th with Justin Silver. Tickets at DanSoder.com. I'm coughing. What video? I sent Christine the Instagram video because we were talking about you would go in. Stephanie Falcone tweeted that she would go in for her dogs if they went overboard.
Yeah, dude.
And then I sent Christine this, and you said you would
Finnegan, if it, Rinnegan's, or Riggins.
Shout out Rinnegan. Shout out Finnegan.
If Rinnegan went in, I'd be right in there.
You just, no hesitation.
Without a doubt.
And it reminded me of this video that I sent you off Barstool. It's two little kids. We'll tweet it out at the bonfire, or you can just see it at Barstool, at Barstool Sports. But these, it's two kids in a living room, and there's a bird loose. See, it's right on the couch.
Got a bird in the house.
The little kid's like, oh, let me touch it. This kid got him. Just fucking grabs the bird. No hesitation. That kid will take lives later. That is, look at that. That's either that man is going to be over in the Middle East doing our army's bidding, or he's going to be building. Look at that. Look at him. He thought it. You saw him think about killing it. Did you see it? He really thought it when he grabbed it. He's like, the power. The power.
I have power?
Why? Right here. He's picking his nose, so he's a loose cannon. And then he's got him.
With the booger hand.
With the booger hand. Just disrespecting the AV.
Reminds me, one time my family went on vacation.
Yeah.
And we were all at the pool. Everything was going nice. The house we ran came to the pool, and then a bird swooped down. It was flying. Mm-hmm. And Zeus fucking snagged it out of the air. Killed it.
What kind of dog was Zeus?
Zeus is a white German shepherd.
Oh, whoa.
He's a wolf, dude.
We're fucking north of the wall shit.
Yeah, shout out Zeus, dude. But Zeus. Killed a bird in front of my family. It was pretty great. My niece was screaming. The bird was like dying.
It's the end of the scene getting shot. We're like, help. I'm a majestic bird.
Yeah, we were hanging out one time on my deck, and my cat, Tybalt. Shout out, Tybalt. What up, bro?
Oh, Shakespearean cat names?
The Prince of Cats, Tybalt.
Yeah, dude. I didn't know you were. I'm so good at Shakespeare.
He brought up a robin that was still alive and just put it on the deck.
Dude.
I went and got a shovel.
It's a gift.
Smashed it.
Oh, woo. That day you became a man.
Let everyone know.
Dude, my dad had this alcoholic roommate named Jim who used to make boats, like remote control little duck boats.
Awesome.
I mean, raging alcoholic. Dude would black out. They had a pump.
But he would black out and make remote control boats?
Dude, he'd just do shit. He made a planet Earth melting from the inside out, and it's on a rock. I still have it. It's at my mom's house. He, like, gave it to me. This dude would just do all this cool arts and crafts shit and drink, like, Barton's vodka and just get hammered. But he had this cat named TC, Tough Cat.
And it not would, the best with names.
Not terrible with names. Great with his hands. Terrible with names. This thing would bring back like lake rodents. Like these giant like rats, like muskrats and shit.
Yeah.
And he would fucking kill them and then bring them back in. And I remember sleeping over there and waking up, and TC brought in this like muskrat. And I was like, oh, I was like a kid who was just dead. Yeah. It was right by the front. And you're like, what?
Yeah, I don't know if it's great radio, but Tybalt one time brought home a rabbit.
Okay.
He was like holding it by its throat, and Tybalt was kind of small. He was a little tiny black cat, but he had a fucking full size rabbit in his mouth. So I opened the sliding door, and Tybalt puts the rabbit down, and then it fucking took off
in the house.
It was playing possum. No, it ran. It ran back into the backyard.
Oh, okay.
Tybalt chases right after. They were going fast as fuck.
Yeah.
Dude. Then he caught him in the middle of the yard and started killing him again. Like, so the rabbit's fucking screaming.
Yeah, it's
rabbits. Oh, rabbits scream, dude.
Yeah, that's rabbit so, like, screaming's fucked up.
So like, I broke it up. I pulled Tybalt. Yeah, he's like Jesus fucking Christ.
Why is this fucking cat? What's this cat's problem?
So I pulled
Tybalt. What's this guy's fucking deal?
I'm holding Tybalt. I pulled him off of him, and I was holding Tybalt's like chest, and he was like, it was fucking crazy. Then I put him down inside.
Yeah.
And as soon as I put him down inside, he scratched me and walked away.
What?
Yeah, it was crazy.
What a badass.
He scratched my leg and walked away.
Does he ever get in my way?
He was like, you're a fucking bitch, dude.
Shay, may I talk to you? You named me Tybalt to be the king of cats. You ever get in my way of killing a rabbit again, I will kill you in your sleep.
Did you kill the rabbit?
No, the rabbit. The rabbit took. It took a while to get him back on his feet.
And you know who that rabbit is, Jacob? You know who that rabbit is? Vice President Joe Biden, who just
that rabbit did become. He ended up becoming Joe Biden. That's why he fucks a lot.
That's right, because he's like a rabbit.
Yep.
Let's. This video. That's.
This is an oldie but a goodie.
Oldie but a goodie that I've never seen. That Shane.
You've never seen this. Oh my god.
I don't think I have.
It's like one of my favorite videos.
At the Bonfire SXM, it's a Scottish mom interrupting her kids, and I don't know. Yeah, sometimes you miss
two little girls trying to record like a song, like they're just filming themselves on a web. Cam trying to sing, and it's great.
I'm going to sing Cher Lloyd by Cher Lloyd or Rebecca G. Then. And don't forget all the trouble we got into.
Why does somebody not know how to flush the toilet after they've had a shit?
What do you mean?
Well, it was fucking one of yes. Disgusting!
Are these guys sitting it? That's so great.
On their webcam.
That's so great.
We're here. We're going to sing a song for you. And it's about dating boys and loving it. And remember, you had to...
Who took a shit?
Which one of you had your shit and didn't flush
Which
the toilet?
Which one of you opened your assholes?
It wasn't me. Well, it was fucking one of yous.
That little girl, when they shut the door, though, that is the pure feeling of utter embarrassment. You're just in front of your sibling and you're like, well... one of us.
One of us. Like, it wasn't me. It's yeah. Like, you little snitch.
Yeah.
It wasn't me.
She's like, fucking, you know, I got to clear the room if I'm going to do a cover.
Forgetting to flush his shit is so funny.
It is so great. I have
just
a better one.
Leaving his shit.
I have one time with Vecchio and I shaved my pubes over the toilet and took a shit and then I left it by accident.
You left the pubes and the shit.
Yeah. And Vecchio's so sweet and mild mannered. He's like, hey, man. So I'll let you know you left a shit behind with some pubes on it. It's like, oh, I'm sorry about that.
You left a shit.
So sorry.
Oh, fuck.
Because I think I was shaving my balls, and then I was like, I got a shit.
Damn.
You got all moist. Got a little bit of humidity.
Oh, and then what happened is you jumped in the shower.
Yes.
Humidity. That's how you forget. That's how you forget the pubes. Humidity. That does happen. Yeah, dude. You got a little humid, loosened your fucking bee.
my C and my B.
That's how I get him loose.
Yeah, Jacob.
I take Jacob to the local YMCA. We go to the sauna for a half hour. And I take him back to his apartment and break him off.
You pulse inside him?
Then I'm like, I'm going to fucking pulse, Jacob.
I'm going to fucking pulse.
You better watch out. You better hang on. I'm about to pulse.
I'm about to bottom jaw fucking pulse. Yeah, this is a video... This is a video of a lady watching the NFL draft, and the guy that gets drafted, Montez Sweat, the DN from Mississippi State.
Go Dawgs.
This one guy just keeps touching him in a weird way. I think he's like trying to get his attention, but this lady's reaction is so goddamn funny. Oh.
Did y'all catch this too?
It's him hugging down his mom, and then this guy
look
just
at dude in the blue
grabs his butt.
About ready to go in for a hump.
Look at the little girl. Why don't you bust her balls?
Look at him. Look at his hands.
Damn.
He's just so weird.
Maybe that's his boyfriend.
Yeah. Is he?
Oh, that's definitely his fucking boyfriend.
Why is he holding him like that? He looks so uncomfortable.
Or do you think he's like his mildly retarded cousin? He's like, I love you, Montez. He goes, you're going to play the NFL now. And he goes, all right.
People watching are like, look at this gay motherfucker. Yeah.
He had a brain injury 3 years ago. He was shot in the skull. He fell off a ladder and it's, oh, fuck. How can we not play this? Dude, you'll love this. Well, by the way, we'll tweet both these videos out at the Bonfire SXM. This is in a gym, guessing somewhere in Asia.
Damn, they just put gyms in malls like that in Asia?
Yeah, dude. Ooh. And this guy's got a weight belt on. He's dressed like an old-timey muscle man.
He really is, man.
And watch how he smacks this low-key Asian guy. Watch what happens. You just see him. And then, by the way, it's from the security camera. He's like, pull! Just slaps him.
Ooh.
And then watch, here comes the other angle. Grabs him by the back of the neck like a cat. That's pretty impressive. You're really sunning someone if you grab him by the back of the neck. You see, he walks away, grabs him by the back of the neck, says something, and boop, knocks him. Gets dropped
right
by that
button.
Dude, that nerd knew accuracy. It's like he knew all the physics behind a fucking knockout
punch.
He's Asian, too, so he calculated it all quick.
Fuck.
He's like, 65, 3, 4, keep going. Guy's in snoozeville.
Man, that's awesome, though. He was doing, like, power cleans at the mall, and then fought a guy right away. He got knocked out.
He's dropping under it, standing up with the bar up on his shoulder.
What'd you fucking say to me?
He goes, drop it. Tink. Did you say that wasn't good form?
Damn.
Did you see my power clean form's not good?
Asian bros?
That's
got to
be
think
great.
About that.
Yeah, they bro out.
That's what that was like one of the craziest things about when I lived in Philly. I lived right near Drexel.
Okay.
And there's a ton of Asians that go to Drexel. And I would go down to the gymnasium occasionally, crush the elliptical.
Yeah.
Stare at the kids.
And, I don't think you should phrase it like that.
I would go stare at those college kids. Good say, Christ. There's thick Asians and they're headed this way. But there's a ton of jacked Asians. I never saw jacked Asians.
There's
just
the
Asians
of,
bro out, dude.
Gee, that's the thing. Arizona.
Asians are bro out.
I went to University of Arizona where a lot of people that you would never expect just broed out. And you're just like, oh, they're getting steroids and wearing tank tops. Yeah, and they're dude. Just like, smash beers Thursday night, it's party yeah. night. And you're like, you were a dork in high school. Not all Asians are dorks, I'm just saying.
What?
What?
What'd you say?
You said you'd never seen a muscular Asian.
There weren't many when I was growing up. Weren't many Asians.
Did you watch movies?
There weren't them. They weren't like fucking thick.
Bloodsport.
Yeah, true. That guy was a thick.
Tom Poe's thick. He's thick enough.
Chinese.
Yeah. I think he's there's thick Asians.
Yeah, also what I'm talking about is thick Asian ladies.
All right, well,
and they're headed. In. There's a fucking tsunami of them headed this way.
Don't lean into it
there's
like
a
that.
Tidal wave. You're like thick Johns, dude.
Look at this guy. These guys will fuck your shit up.
I'll crush them, dude.
No, you will not.
The day a fucking Asian.
Dude, you're just signing. Look at that guy. Look at how shredded that guy is.
No, that Asian would fucking work me, dude.
Dude, he would beat the shit out of you. Look at his legs. Look at those quads, Jacob. Oof. Come on.
He's going to destroy you.
You think he's going to destroy me?
Yeah, come on, man.
Look at that. That guy will beat the fuck out of you.
Min Q Lee?
Yeah, Min Q Lee will just eat your lunch. And then, look, he's a bodybuilder.
So?
See, look, Karen's going.
I am sliding off this chair right now.
Ew, Karen. Don't be disgusting.
There is a first time for everything.
Don't be disgusting.
Stop.
Come on, it's all a bunch
of agree with me. She don't be difficult.
Obviously, this guy's fucking hot. That doesn't mean I wouldn't knock him out at the mall.
He would definitely. You think if he's power cleaning
he's
in the mall.
He's power cleaning.
You're walking to a finish line.
I'm crushing, crushing Annie Ann's.
Yeah.
I've been at Annie Ann's. I get back in line at Annie Ann's.
You're with one of your baby girls.
Several baby girls flocking.
Flocking. You're walking through the mall, going to get a new.
Like, is that the fat guy that was in a tracksuit at GameStop for a half hour playing on the fucking free sample?
Did that guy see if he could play classic Crash Bandicoot at GameStop? He made a scene of it. I'm a ma'am.
Next thing I know, yeah, true. Next thing I know, a fucking jacked Asian's up in my shit.
He's doing power cleans. Probably doing, what, three sets of three?
He sees me doing, I see his light work on the cleans. I give him a little, as I dip another cinnamon stick.
Is that what starts the fight?
Yeah, he's trying to rep, yeah, he's repping like 225 on the cleans.
225, I think he's probably doing five.
I walk by, I'm just like.
And then he's like.
I say, that is very dishonorable.
He goes like this, hey, can I talk to you real quick? I don't talk like that.
Yeah, he's like, hey, man.
Hey, I'm from San Mateo.
I'm like, what's your name?
He's Chris.
Min Q Lee.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I could have guessed that. Next thing I know, I'm taking a slap.
Look at this guy. Look at this guy hey, coming blasting. Over to fuck your mom.
Who, Chuan Du Tan?
He's like a He-Man toy.
I bet he does tan.
He looks like a He-Man toy. Kevin Lowe?
Damn, that guy's back has abs.
Did you know Asians can do back abs?
Look at that. Dude, he's
flying.
He's flying.
I mean.
I knew they could fly.
Yeah, I've seen the movies. Look at this guy. Look at this go.
Wow.
Imagine him doing that to your girl, just climbing all around.
Nothing climbing you can all
do.
Over?
Nothing you can do.
Dude.
Look at that. I am begging for mercy after just a half of one of those moves. I mean, that's a little obnoxious. This guy's got core.
Now imagine that at Drexel, and I'm just on the elliptical.
Puffing and puffing.
I'm just like, 15 minutes is longer than I thought it would. I'm going to do 10.
You know what? I've been a good boy.
What's that, Chipotle across the street?
Yeah.
I'm going to get a burrito.
I'm going to get a burrito. I'm yeah, dude, all these guys are so jacked. You're just done.
Yeah, but they still don't, like, they wear goofy shit. Like, that guy's wearing, look at that. Dude, look at his shoes. He's wearing, like, fucking.
It's a woman's yoga outfit.
He looks great in it.
Well, they're
it
just,
fills it out.
These guys are just figuring out clothes.
What? Just figuring out
they're
clothes.
Trying to fucking assimilate, so they're going to just picking shit out.
No, he looks like he's a gay painter, like a gay house painter. Yeah, dude, they'll fuck your that guy'll fuck your shit up. Huang Chul Soon, yeah, fucking put you to sleep.
Yeah,
look
right.
at that guy. Play it. Let his legs pop.
Good lord,
Chul Soon, body. He's got a little tiny butt. Look at a little tiny butt. Yeah, it's my move. Yeah. I was here. Oh. That's him dancing after he just beat your ass. This is him answering your girl's door. You go over, you're like, what's up? What are you doing here? He's just in
there. So who the fuck is that? Who the fuck is that at your door?
That's Chol Soon.
He's full. He's front porching it.
That's Chol, Shane.
I met Chol at Drexel.
Chol, he's from Drexel.
Look at him, just fucking locking it out. Pow!
Like, hey, dude, could you fucking take this shit somewhere else?
Also, why are you in your underwear and sneakers, you alcoholic?
Yeah, bro.
That's the end of my career right there. Nah. All right, we're going to keep this thing going.
Go back up. I could rock that last guy.
Him?
Yeah.
No way.
What are you talking about? Preston?
Dude, hit the video. We got video to show you how. Look at that. Incline.
Easy.
3x6.
I've been lifted in like 3 years. Easy, dude. Three sets of eight on the bench, 225. Come on, bro.
Yeah.
Light work.
Oh, yeah?
Take him? Fuck no. No, all these guys would kill me.
Yeah. I just like him answering. It's like that guy being at your girlfriend's house.
That guy, if you get that, what's that shit you guys were promoting about the
blink camera?
If you got a blink cam and you're looking out and you see Chol Soon out there breaking it down.
Yeah.
And you're on business.
You're on business.
You're
and
just
he's
checking that fucking blink cam and you're like.
It's just him without those undies and those sneakers just blasting
honey,
ass.
What's going on here?
For grip on the floor.
What's Chol doing here again?
It's Chol. He's my trainer.
You're like, summon Chol?
Did you summon him? Did you summon him?
Oh, wow. There's a hole.
Oh, look at this guy.
That's all him.
Look, I'll play that video of him on a boat just flexing on Shane.
Why is he flexing on me? Why
he hates
sounds
you.
Like he's flexing on you.
No, me and Chol are boys.
Chol would rock you, dude.
Dude, Chol and I are boys. He wouldn't
look
do that.
He's on. He's sailing on his way to you. He's coming to your house.
He hates you.
He fucking hates you.
Look at how jacked he is. And he says he hates you so much. These kids
I
love
like
him.
Those guys.
That's so funny. Even in Asia, they're like, what? We got a muscular one?
Yeah. I'm more into docile Asians.
What?
The docile ones.
Chol ain't docile,
Chol
bro.
Chol is a wild bull.
He is.
He'll get loose.
He'll just start fucking
look at
bucking.
Dude, he's pointing to the flag. Vietnam, number one. We're still number one. You try to ruin it.
Dude, he doesn't wear shirts. This guy does not wear shirts.
Remember when you tried to ruin Vietnam? Now I'm jacked.
Yeah.
Fuck yo.
I'm back to fuck shit up. He's there, Arnold. All right. Well, I think Shane's point was not proven.
What are you talking about?
Muscular Asians have existed
dude,
for
we
a
Googled
while.
Muscular Asians and we found 10. You know how many fucking Asians there are?
How many?
Fucking bunch. Bunches of them, dude. You ever heard of a billion?
Yeah.
It's a little more than that.
I wonder if that, back to that NFL player, I wonder if he's, because NFL players still aren't coming out. No, I mean, remember it? Like, everyone thought it was going to happen with, what's the dude from Missouri?
Michael Sam.
Everyone's like, oh, people are going to start coming out now. That's really cool what that could be.
Yeah, that could just be a gay dude.
You think he's gay, Black Lou? Or do you think it was just...
That guy was definitely gay or, again...
I think that guy was either gay or really trying to get on TV.
Do you think you want to get on TV that bad that you start rubbing your friend's back like you're about to fuck him?
Although if you did get drafted, I would definitely
rub
your
like
ass
that?
Or try to grab your dong.
I would be
if,
fine.
If I knew the camera was on you.
I was talking and they go, Dan, you're going to Indianapolis. You're a cult. How do you feel? I'm like, stop, Shane. Stop it. I'm just really proud to play for such a great organization.
When we were on NXT, I tried to deep throat your finger.
Yeah. You didn't get it.
Didn't pull it off.
We were going to kiss, and then David Shoemaker was like, they'll pull away, and then just come back and remove you guys. And I was like, damn it.
Yeah, so I was trying to get his hand to fucking...
I should have Aziz'd you.
Oh.
What? Is that... You're such a shit starter that even when you go to try to be a shit starter with Shane, he shit starts with you. Shane flips it again. You know what I mean? You're like, hey, right, Shane? He goes, I don't know. That's kind of weird.
I would never say something like that.
Yes, you would.
I would never be that inappropriate.
You're always that inappropriate. Dude,
yeah, dude.
I don't even know you anymore. Just because Chun fucking punked you.
Chun and me are fucking pals, dude. I guarantee me and him are Instagram friends already.
Did you follow him?
Fuck, dude, I followed Chol a long time ago. I'm surprised you guys just found Chol Soon. I found him a while ago.
I said it. I called him Chun. Chol,
what up,
oh,
bro?
Look at him doing those deadlifts. Bringing the deadlifts up. How much is that? 6 plates?
I think he's training to fight Godzilla.
I don't think that's the thing that they... Maybe, is that how they train there?
Yeah.
That's their fucking pumping iron?
Like, you better be ready.
Yeah, there's no way. Dude, that guy would just, you wonder if bodybuilders can fight.
I mean, that guy is so strong that even if he couldn't fight, like him just grabbing you.
Him grabbing you, he could crush you like like Jacob's favorite character in Game of Thrones.
Why do you like that little girl?
Yeah, but he was
you
a heartthrob.
You loved a little girl?
Lady Mormont?
Yeah.
She's a badass. Come on. You like her.
I genuinely don't like her.
Really?
Yeah. We were talking about last night.
Yeah. Shane and Vecchione were saying that they don't like that a little girl stood up at a war council meeting and started barking orders.
Obviously, it's a fantasy show, but it's like, come on. We're gonna pretend that?
That she's just standing up and punking a bunch of
that was
of
the
fucking,
order. I mean, that's the whole...
She's like fucking 10.
I don't like vegetables. I don't want to eat.
If you had a kid controlling your house,
you're just stuck behind her. Yeah, you're just some fucking general. Like, please don't fucking say that about vegetables.
I fought with your father.
We gotta actually tell them we're not fighting for them.
I fought with your father and released your house from the tyranny. Please do not say you want stickers. It makes us look weak.
We gotta stop going into these meetings asking for stickers.
Please stop asking for stickers. You're a 10-year-old girl, and I respect that.
Please, God.
But please, you're making us look very weak.
I don't like the way it smells in here. It doesn't smell like bubblegum and candy.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Fucking A. I fucking
eating alive at these goddamn debates.
I've killed 40 men that I know of with a blade. Close. Personal.
She fires him. He's like, you know what? I hope a fucking giant breaks in here and fucking squeezes you to death.
Oh, bitch, I hope you get crushed one day. You're going to get crushed, you little bitch.
I got a good feeling someone's going to squeeze you to death, lady.
You're a little bitch.
Well, you're fired. I'm the queen. I'm the head of my house.
Yeah, dude.
That's your favorite character?
No, I think Joffrey's my favorite.
Hell yeah. All right. Yeah. So we got to agree.
That's so weird.
My top five.
What a swing. It's, by the way, Jacob's, I don't know if you noticed, both picks, children.
Joffrey's a monster. Yeah. He's great.
He's a monster.
He was so much better as a bad guy than the new bad guy that's with Cersei.
Yeah, that's like a...
That guy stinks.
He looks like, I call him Bad Liev Schreiber.
He really does.
He looks like
exactly
evil
right.
Like Wario Liev Schreiber.
Yeah, that guy sucks.
Dude, Game of Thrones, you know, people are like, I saw a tweet about Billions. They're like, isn't it fucked up to Koppelman, the creator of Billions? And he's like, what are you talking about? He's like, Game of Thrones is a phenomenon. He's like, people will watch Billions. He's like, it's not the ratings anymore. It's not the fucking 80s. Because everyone I know watched Game of Thrones. And like people that
it's streaming. You don't, I mean, Game of Thrones you watch live. Because you're excited for it to come out.
But it's the last season. It's also the last fucking four episodes.
Yeah.
Like Jay's Blade 4, when Blade 4 comes out in the theaters.
I'll be at the midnight showing.
Yeah, we'll probably go to the premiere.
Damn, where do they have, where's the premiere? It's like Topeka?
Yeah, I heard he's dressed like Van Helsing. Jay's playing Van Helsing in the new Blade 4 movie.
It's going to be awesome.
Man, if we could really get that to trend on Twitter.
He does dress like a vampire hunter.
Yeah.
You had that right.
Yeah,
gloves and shit.
If he told you, by the way, I do know that there's a new Corey Feldman video. We will not touch it until Jay's back, out of respect, because it's great.
Rolling Stone.
Yeah, did you watch it?
No, I haven't seen it, the whole thing yet. I just saw that it exists.
What's the Feld Dog up to?
It's classic Feld Dog. originally, in the first 6 seconds, I was like, oh man, god damn, I can't wait to watch this. Why don't you just come back on when Jay's back?
Let me know, bro. You know I'm fucking hanging out every day.
I don't know. You're going to be out getting old pussy.
You know I'm doing nothing.
You're just out fucking gilts.
What time? Yeah, the show starts right around when I'm laying pipe. When they're going to bed at 6.
You give her that 5:30 fucking early bird special. What's the oldest you'd go? Honestly.
Honestly?
55?
Yeah, dude.
Like a hot 55.
Please.
60.
Bump it up, dog.
65. You'd fuck. That's,
I would fuck a 65-year-old.
Isn't that AARP? Isn't that like official retirement age? You'd fuck a 65-year-old.
You wouldn't fuck a 65-year-old?
No.
That's like my parents' age. And they got my mom has some friends I would fucking bust a nut on.
Do you pulse all over?
I would fucking pulse on a few of her friends. brittle bones, dude. Oh. I'd be like that giant with Lady Mormont or whatever.
You'd be crushing their fucking...
squeeze them to death. Kiss of death, dude.
Yeah. Like, Shane,
that's
you
what I call
fuck,
my finishing move.
Did you fuck Janet?
I would squeeze her and crush her ribcage as I pulse.
Shane, please stop.
No fucking pulse,
Shane,
lady.
Shane, stop it, please.
You're about to meet Jesus.
You're friends with my son. You guys are 2 years difference. We used to go to the pool together.
I can't believe I'm fucking you and now you killed me.
I can't believe you killed me after you fucked me.
You fucked me and then you killed me.
Yeah, dude, that's 65 is... Jacob, what's the oldest you'd go? 60?
70s where you 70s the cap.
55?
70's the cap? That's lawlessness.
70's about the cap.
It's crazy.
You can run into some...
I'd say 55's the cap.
Yeah.
You can run into some hot 60-year-olds for sure. My dad.
Phil Gillis just getting everyone boned
Phil
up.
Phil fucking chub someone to death.
Older men are a different story, though. Like, older men... It's true. Older men, right?
Yes.
Well, there's two women in the room. Karen, what's the oldest you would go?
Oh, that's so hard. How rich is he?
Very.
Keep
very
in mind.
What color is he?
Whoa.
Black dude.
Okay. Don't crack. So let's go up to, I'll go 55.
55?
I'm very young. It's very old for me, 55.
I think girls need to know, keep in mind, Trump's 72.
Yeah.
So that should probably be. And you guys would definitely get punched
by Trump.
You know
what? I have to walk that back because, like, legally, I just feel like there's advantages to going really, really old.
So, like, 85.
He's going to fucking kick it.
Yeah, but are you going for that? I'm saying you got to.
Kick it!
I would Anna Nicole that shit.
Do you want.
I have
you,
student loans.
So you want to fuck for money.
You
went
to school?
I'm not. I'm saying you had a. This is for fucking. That's all this is.
It's just for fucking.
Yeah, this is nothing to do with situational. This is you getting bound. You have to come. You have to come.
Oh, shit.
You have to come. I mean, Shane, I don't.
Honestly, let's be reasonable. Let's say 55. Let's
55.
Be real. Yeah.
All right.
I can't go 55.
You can't?
60?
Yeah. Again, Trump's 72.
There's LA and New York 55, which is
LA 55.
It's not middle of the country. 55.
That's a soggy 55, dude. That's a rough go. That's a C-section scar.
Mm. Well, but the guy from Def Leppard, he's 61. He was ripped.
He was jacked. Look at that guy. How old's this guy?
Who the fuck is that?
I'm trying to find out.
German
exactly how
douche.
Old it is,
Silver
like,
fox.
What kind of daddy is that?
Dude, that guy.
That is a sad fucking weirdo. Oh my God. If one of my friends. If you're young and you post a picture like that, you suck.
Yeah. Oh my God. He's an old man. How old is he?
I don't know.
I think he's young. I think he dyes his hair.
He better not be too old,
like
dude.
He's 1,000.
No, his face is not old.
He's German. He better not be too old.
Well,
you know what I'm talking about?
He might be remembering some things.
Don't forget about those people. He does have a lot of tattoos.
As far as I in 1942.
Might be covering up some.
It's kind of like the Nazis won in this case.
What does this say? What's the name of this article on BuzzFeed? 15 stunning silver foxes that will awake your inner thirst. Ugh. Do they just have computer programs coming up
really
with these?
Really is. They just spin a wheel.
Fucking idiot. What idiot wrote that headline?
And they're like, hey, how can we tell girls to be sluts today?
Yeah. This gorgeous glass-wearing god. Guy probably sucks. The following who's
damn.
I mean,
that's like a thick Tom Hanks.
That's perfect.
Dude, he's thick. Oh, he's Jewish. Shit.
Yeah.
Oh, different guy.
Oh, that's the guy that dances on the boat.
Yeah. Ugh.
I like Shane looking at handsome old men.
Old guys trying to be hot.
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, dude, that guy sucks.
Love it when a guy compliments my vibe.
Yeah, these guys stink. At the Bonfire, SXM will tweet it out.
Ugh.
These guys really suck.
To see all these dudes in the same room as those thick Asians and just have them go at it.
Oh,
thick Asians, I would love to release them on these old geezers.
Here you go. Chun!
Oh, release the boys, dude.
Get them going. Fucking get them all mall riled
up. Release the fucking chungs. release the fucking chungs, dude.
That's Shane M. Gillis on Instagram and on Twitter. Love you, buddy. Thanks for coming
in. Yeah, man. May 11th. Come to Helium. I'll be
yes.
Helium in Philly, May 11th.
Late show, May 11th.
Show.
Go buy tickets to see Shane Gillis headline in Philadelphia at Helium, helium.com for tickets. Make sure you go. Also, check out Big J in Columbus this Friday and Saturday at the Funny Bone. Then Caroline's, May 16th through the 19th, BigJComedy.com, DanSoder.com for tickets for the Laugh Shop in Calgary, May 9th through the 11th, then Comedy Connection, May 17th and 18th. Man, you talk a lot. Then you got to burp.
Mm-hmm.
I love you. Thanks for coming in.
I love you. Thank I love you. All of you guys. Christine?
We love you too, but you still have to grow that beard, buddy.
CC.com/bonfire. You got smoked in that poll, dude.
Fuck. Yeah, 83. It's 17 to 83 right
Ooh,
now.
Ooh, a little comeback.
No,
we're
at 82.
We're climbing, Jacob.
You're at 82.
Climbing.
We'll see you tomorrow. Crackle, crackle.
Bye.